My name is Tony Caggiano. I want my Medford Square TV.
Hi, this is Scott Harney from Medford Square TV in the basement of the Medford Transcript Office in the middle of Medford Square. This is show number 9, and unfortunately it's my last show for a while because I'm going to Cairo, Egypt later this week. But we will have a number of guest hosts throughout this summer. The show will continue with Joe Fortunato here behind the camera. How you doing, Joe?
Okay. Hey, everybody.
Great. Now, we're going to go to Lynn Diana Coney, the Executive Director of the Chamber of Commerce, who's interviewing Kathy Clifford at the Century Bank.
Hi, I'm Lynn Diana Coney, Executive Director of the Medford Chamber of Commerce. I'm here at the Executive Operations Center of Century Bank on Mystic Ave with Kathy Clifford, our new president for 1992-1993. Kathy, what do you think we have in store for this year?
Well, my hopes, as you know, Linda, are to raise the numbers in our membership. Membership is our bloodline, and we're hoping to get more and more members to join our great chamber here in the city of Medford. Our other goals are to get more and more people involved in what we're trying to accomplish this year, namely the directors and officers. In that respect, we are planning a full-blown directors meeting on June 18th at the Happy Haddock, and hopefully all will be able to attend.
And Kathy, speaking of new members, we do have a few this month, and we'd like to list them. And it's Brigham's at 61 High Street in Medford Square, Avellino's Restaurant, 313 Mystic Ave, which is right down the street from the Century Bank, Alberino and Sons at 55 Gleason Street, Personal Management Company at 19 Gleason Street. And Kathy hasn't been involved with the chamber for quite a few years, but we just have to say something, I think, Kathy, about our wonderful committee for our float for the parade, which we run third prize for in the community division. So Kathy, why don't you do the honors?
Okay, you're quite right, Linda. There are so many people who were involved in our float, and it was the success it was because of these kind of people. I would like to thank, and on your behalf also, Michael Alberino and his brother Rick, who built that magnificent ship. It caused a lot of controversy within the city weeks prior to the parade. You know, everybody was trying to guess what is going on Gleason Street.
Riding by Michael's house.
They're building a ship. What's going on? Well, that was our ship, and it was wonderful, and we thank Mike and Rick so much. And then to the decorators and to our ship builders on board, Dave Boudreau, Deanne Robichaud, Stan Comans, John Pompeo, David Delarusso, Marco DeCipio, and the two gals, Linda and Kathy.
And if you'd like to know who our hairdresser was on that day, just call the chamber and we'll be glad to tell you.
And we'll try and locate them and shoot them down. But it was great. It was wonderful to see such great camaraderie on the streets. I've never seen such spirit in the city of Medford. It was wonderful to be up there waving to old friends, new friends.
Elbow, hand to hand.
Chamber members. It was a thrill, and it was a great experience for me, and I think it was a great experience for the city of Medford in general. I have never seen such a day put together.
It was beautiful.
And the weather was beautiful.
In this city. Everything was terrific, and I think we owe a lot to the mayor and his centennial committee for putting Medford back on the map, even if it was for that day. We were talked about within many, many communities, and I'm still hearing so many positive things about it, not only in the city of Medford, but the city of Boston and area cities as well.
People came from all over. I spoke to somebody down at the fireworks from New Hampshire. People were here from New Hant. We just had a great day, and we have to thank everybody. Everybody did a terrific job. Kathy, I'd like to thank you and Marshall Sloan for letting Medford Square TV come into Century Bank on Mystic Ave and do a little piece here. And I think we would be remiss if we didn't say somebody that we're going to miss around the chamber office, and you've been coming into the chamber and you know, is Scott Harney from the Medford Transcript. And Kathy, I think, would you like to say something to Scott?
Sure. Scott, I know this was a very hard decision for you to make, going off to, above all places, Cairo, Egypt, but I know you're going to do a fabulous job, just as you've done a fabulous job here in the city of Medford, and you've made the Transcript the great paper that it is. You've been very supportive of the chamber, and we certainly appreciate it, And we know you'll be back soon. We wish you well for now. I won't say goodbye. I'll just say so long. Thank you, Scott.
And come home, whether it's 3 months from now or a year from now. We wish you the best. Bye now.
Okay, thank you both, Linda and Kathy. Now we have Marshall Sloan, the president of the Century Bank, with a message for the citizens of Medford.
Well, I just want to say that we at Century are extremely pleased and proud of our Kathy Clifford. Kathy has been with us for in excess of 20 years, started here as a young girl, I believe at 18 years old, and we've watched her grow, mature, and become a sophisticated banking executive. Now we know that with her new role, along with banking, she, as president of the Medford Chamber of Commerce, that she will do an outstanding job in promoting the city of Medford. Century's relationship goes a long way in the city of Medford. I can't say we go back 100 years, but my parents, when they first got married, lived on 70 Medford Street in Medford, and we also have been long, in fact, I was born on Smith Street, so I know that I've had a long relationship with the city of Medford. We're proud, and proud to be part of their 100th anniversary celebration.
Well, thank you, Mr. Sloan. Now we're here with Medford's Melissa Hurley, who is going to be one of the guest hosts this summer for the show. She's a student at Seton Hall University. You just completed your freshman year, right?
Yeah, I just came home last Thursday.
Great. And how did you do this semester?
Well, I hope I did well. Last semester I was in the dean's list, so hopefully again this
great
semester.
And you're majoring in communications?
Yes, I majored in communications, and I hope to work in the public relations field.
Oh, good.
Maybe as an entertainment agent or as a news commentator.
Well, that's great. And now you're the daughter of Dan Hurley, Governor's Counsel.
Yes, I am.
And he's a good guy. And you're also a graduate of Medford High School?
Mm-hmm.
And that was last year you graduated?
Yes, 91.
Okay. And now I understand you're a freshman representative at Seton Hall. Tell me a little bit about that.
Well, I was elected freshman representative this year. And what it was I worked with other representatives from the sophomore, junior, and senior class. And we worked to make the Seton Hall community a better school by different fundraisers and different trips to the city and stuff like that.
Okay, Melissa, tell me a little bit about Seton Hall. I understand a number of prominent Medford people have gone there.
Yes, well, Angie Murata went there, and Representative Tony Giglio's son, Tony, is a junior there right now.
Oh, did you see him while you were on campus?
Yes, I'm friends with him, so.
Oh, that's
and we
great.
Have the same major, so I've seen him a lot. And there's not really many other people from Medford, but there's a lot of people from Malden, and there's really a lot of people from the Boston area.
Right.
Every day I seem to meet someone new from Massachusetts.
And it's located in New Jersey?
Yes, about 40 minutes outside of New York City, in South Orange, New Jersey.
So did you get to the city at all?
A few times. Yeah, I went to see Phantom of the Opera a couple weeks ago.
That's great.
On Broadway.
So did you miss Medford while you were away?
Yeah, well, you know, it was fun meeting all these new people and the whole college atmosphere. And I had a lot of fun there, but, you know, Medford is my hometown, and I always missed it.
Now, Melissa, I know a lot of people in Medford will recognize you from your picture in the paper concerning your modeling career. And how is that going? I know you've...
It's going very well, thank you. I'm involved in a modeling agency in New Jersey, where I did a few fashion shows for. And right now, it's more of a hobby than a career. I don't really look at it as a career because it's very... you have to be in the right place at the right time, more or less, that kind of career. But I like it as a hobby, and I really enjoy doing it. And right now I have a few things lined up for the summer.
Like what?
Well, over my spring break, I talked to a modeling agency in the Boston area that was interested in me. And I'm supposed to meet with them next week. So we'll see what happens
from
that.
Well, good luck.
Thank you.
I understand you began your interest in broadcast TV. You know, you're a communications major, so this sort of ties in well.
Yeah, I think it does, because it's all performance, I feel, anyway.
That's good. Okay, very good. Well, nice talking with you. We'll see more of you this summer one of the hosts of Medford Square
TV.
And
good luck in Egypt.
Oh, thank you. Now, I understand you've been in the Middle East before.
Yes, I've been there twice.
Yeah, so what were your impressions of it?
I thought the people were very nice. It was very beautiful land. I was in India, Bombay, India, for a couple of weeks, and the United Arab Emirates, which is near Kuwait. And I met a lot of nice people there, and it was a very nice time. It was a very different experience, though.
Good. Okay, well, good luck.
Okay, thank you.
I'm Eric Giordano, and I want my Medford Square TV now.
Okay, now here's Fran Giordano, Mr. Controversy, with more news on sports.
Thank you, Scott. Well, hello, sports fans. I'm Fran Giordano for Medford Square TV Sports. Well, it's been a while since we were on, but we're back, and we're back in style. The last time we were on, we were talking about the Celtics, and the Celtics at the time were red hot. Well, if the Celts are hot now, it's because they're on the beach enjoying the summer vacation. But the Celtics, who were eliminated 4-3 by the Cleveland Cavaliers in the Eastern Conference semifinals. It was a tough loss in the seventh game, but we still feel good about their loss because the Celtics, I feel, did this area and the Boston sports fans a lot of good. The Celtics, we all remember, they were plagued with injuries this year. They had big key injuries to Bird, to Brown, Bagley, McHale, and they still came through, and we're proud of them here at Medford Square TV. And one of the bright spots was the emergence of Reggie Lewis as a legitimate all-star. In the absence of Bird, Reggie played above and beyond the call of duty and was honored by his players in the league this year by making the all-star squad. So things are looking better for the Celtics. One of the big questions, I guess, for the summer of 92 will be Larry Bird versus retirement. And a lot of people feel that this could be the last time they'll see Larry in a Celtic uniform. He hasn't quite announced it yet, but we'll probably know after the Summer Olympics. And speaking of the Olympics, this could be a great way for Larry Bird to end the career. You win the gold, you go out in style. Let's face it, Larry had a great career during the 80s. They brought the championship home to Boston 3 or 4 times. What better way, what fitting way for a champ to go out in style? So we wish him the best, and we'd rather see him go out like that. How about let's turn over to the Boston Gardens and staying at the Gardens with the co-tenants of the Celtics, the Boston Bruins. The Bruins, you remember, are in the same position as the Celtics were. They were red hot. They swept Montreal 4-0. But again, they got beaten pretty soundly by the Pittsburgh Penguins, the defending Stanley Cup champions, 4-0. The Bruins, same season the Celtics had. They were in kind of parallel to each other. They were hit with some key injuries. They lost Cam Neely for the year. They had Glenn Featherstone out for the year. Bobby Carpenter playing every other game. So they lost a lot of gold production. And they still came through. And let's face it, the Bruins made the Final Four. As bad as a season as everyone was complaining about, they made the Final Four. So I think the Bruins, as well as the Celtics, had a great year. And we're waiting for next year because another bright spot, look at the resurgence of these kids such as Joe Juneau from the Canadian Olympic team, Teddy Donato, Steve Hines. These kids had a super, super end of the year, and I'll tell you, it looks good. With the addition of Adam Oates, maybe Cam Neely returning, we're predicting a good season for the Bruins next year. And the final Stanley Cup playoffs will have the Penguins against the Blackhawks, and we'll keep you informed of that in a later edition. And right now, we're moving on to baseball. But, you know, right now, I mean, who cares about baseball? It's for the birds. For the birds? Right. Right now, the American League East has the Toronto Blue Jays and the Baltimore Orioles battling for the top spot. The two bird teams neck and neck, and we were predicting Toronto to be there, but we're surprised that Baltimore is still there. But Red Sox fans, let's not despair. We're only 4 games out. With all the bad luck, the cold weather we've been having, the Sox are only 4 games out. And remember, it's a long way to go before the season ends. They're going out to the West Coast. They're going for the warm weather. They love the warm weather. Look what's happened when the warm weather came to Fenway. And how about Butch Hobson? We called him up 3 weeks ago. Remember we said, Butch, don't let Wade Boggs lead off. He doesn't like it. Put him back into third spot. He did. And look at how hot Boggs is. 3 home runs in 2 days. I don't think he's done that in his life. And he's just having a great time batting third. Thank you, Butch, for listening to us. And we'll keep you informed with some more tips throughout the rest of the year. Some other notables in baseball, how about Mark McGwire? Whew, 17 home runs, he's tearing up the league. 17 home runs, as a matter of fact, that's as many as the whole Red Sox team, 17 home runs. So Mark is having an outstanding year, and he's going to probably silence the critics because of his not-too-lesser year last year. And finally, we'd like to give our congratulations to the Unser family. Al Unser's son, Al Jr., had an outstanding day at the Indianapolis 500, bringing home the cup for the family. And it was just a great race. A lot of crashes, if anyone caught the race. Outstanding action. And congratulations to Al Jr. And now we'd like to make an announcement here at Medford Square TV Sports. For anybody involved in Little League Baseball, Youth Baseball, soccer, if you Babe Ruth leagues, any announcements you would like, we would broadcast them with no problem right here on Medford Square TV. Just bring your announcements right here to Fran Giordano. You can bring them in here at Arthur's Pastry Shop, and we'll be glad to put them on for our next edition. Now we're moving to our trivia question. The last question we had was, who was the youngest player to ever pitch in the major leagues? And we didn't get any, we got a few answers, but no correct answers. One of the answers was close, played for Cincinnati, but the correct answer was Joe Nuxall, and he was only 15 and a half years old. Wasn't even old enough to drive, but he pitched in the Cincinnati Red Leagues in 1956. This week's question, we're going to go with a little bit easier question this week, and we want to get more people involved. Do you remember who was the catcher for the Boston Red Sox in the 1986 World Series against the New York Mets when they had the wild pitch or the pass ball, depending on your opinion? Who was that Red Sox catcher? If you know the question, and you know, I mean, if you know the answer, rather, just send it in to Medford Square TV Sports, Post Office Box 379, Medford, Mass. And the correct answer will receive, once again, a beautiful picture of Babe Ruth and Lou Gehrig, courtesy of Arthur's Pastry Shop. So if you know that answer, jot it down, and we'll send out this picture, courtesy of Arthur's, right to you. And finally, we have a sad note here at Medford Square Sports. It's because we're losing a colleague of ours, Scott Harney. We want to wish you the best. Scott has a job. He just got a job for Cairo Today. It's one of the largest English-speaking papers, journals in Cairo, Egypt. And Scott's going to be going over there. He's leaving us, and we wish him the very best. So, Scott, good luck, and we'll be thinking well of you all the time. And for Medford Square TV Sports, this is Fran Giordano. Till next edition.
Thanks, Fran, for your insightful comments on the world of sports. Now we have Joe Fortunato with some Medford social news.
Thank you, Scott. Recently, Marissa Guarino of Medford celebrated her first communion at the Immaculate Conception Church. Marissa's parents, Frank and Eileen Guarino, and her grandparents, Rosemary and Frank Scaletta of Grant Ave, were very pleased to attend. It was really a wonderful celebration. As you can see, there were many, many youngsters attending and celebrating the same day. But Marissa's parents and grandparents were also very pleased to celebrate Marissa's birthday, which came at the same time. Marissa received many presents, and she's a lovely girl, as you can see. Also in social news, Valentina and Armando Federico of Wareham Street were very happy to have a big celebration in honor of the christening of their newest grandchild, Carly Federico, the daughter of Michelle and Vincent Federico. The celebration was held at a local Italian restaurant. Here's Carly with her sister and her parents, Michelle and Vinnie Federico. It was a great time, and Medford Square TV wants to congratulate the entire Federico family. Also in social news, the social event of the spring. Yes, the wedding of Lisa Reed and Mark McCauley. It was held recently at St. Francis Parish and officiated by Father Robert Casey. Everyone from St. Francis Parish and everyone here at Medford Square TV wants to congratulate and wish the best to Lisa and Mark McCauley. Just look at them. What a great, great looking couple. Now here's Melissa Hurley.
Thanks, Joe. Now I'd like to tell you about a block party that we had on Memorial Day. It was on Saltonstall Road, which is off of Grove Street, and included many of the surrounding streets. It was a great time by all, as there was much food, fun, and dancing, entertainment. Now here's Hannah Diozzi speaking with Susan Fido.
Having a block party.
Oh, I think we probably started about 2 years before we actually held it. We kept saying, wouldn't it be fun to have a block party? I wonder how hard it would be to do it. It must not be too hard. And then last year,
Well, last year we decided we would just bite the bullet and do it, and we printed up some flyers and we walked the neighborhood, a lot of streets around here, but then we kind of ran out of steam. We were doing this after dinner and getting invited into a lot of houses for a little party, pre-block party partying.
Right, right.
And we just didn't get to invite a couple of streets last year, so this year we included them. But this is the second time, and everybody was very responsive, and it's not a whole lot of work, and the whole thing just fell into place.
And in spite of the weather, which is absolutely dreadful today, it seems to be working out very well. And I told Hannah this morning that we should cancel, and she said, no, people will come even if it isn't raining. So why don't we ask some of the people about why they came?
We're delighted that we came in time for the Saltonstall block party.
My name is Lou Bertacci. I live at 55 Saltonstall. This is the second annual block party we've had, and I tried to get Mr. Afito to discuss the presidential incumbents and the presidential election, but he shied away from it. The big question that we have here that we're discussing all over the place is what we're going to do with Mr. Quayle. But I will leave that to others. But this is one thing that we had today. We have similar weather as we had last year, except that we haven't got rain yet, but we expect it in about a half an hour.
Wonderful.
Yeah. I don't know who am I speaking to?
Just give your name for it.
No, seriously. Hi, I'm Deb Dellerfano. I live on Saltonstall Road, and we've been having neighborhood parties of one sort or another for many years, but this is the second official block party, and it's a great thing to do. I recommend it highly for all neighborhoods. It's a good way to get to know your friends.
If you want to sing, getting to know you.
A prediction on? On my book? I'm not writing a book.
My name is Beth, and I live on 43 Saltonstall Road.
My name is Stephanie. I live at 44 Saltonstall Road.
My name is Rachel. I live on 29 Wellgate Road.
I'm David Fito. My wife Susan and Hannah have been among other neighbors who have helped organize the block party. It is the highlight of the year. We all come out and stand shivering in 48 degree weather and talk to all our neighbors we have not seen in the last year. And it's a nice tradition. So we're all happy to be here.
Hi, my name's Patrick.
Hi, my name is Liam, here.
Hi, my name is Nicholas.
Hi, my name is Carter.
Here.
Hi, my name is Vinny. Here.
Hi, my name's Bob.
Hi.
I'm Medford Square TV.
You're a grand old flag, you're a high-flying flag, and forever in peace, mighty way. You're the emblem of the land I love, the home of the free and the free. Every heart beats through under red, white, and blue, where there's never a boast or a brag. But you all acquaintance be forgot, keep your eye on the grand old flag.
Hi, I'm Lorraine Marino from Wellgate Road.
And Dan Hurley from Wellgate Road, enjoying this great Memorial Day bash here on Saltonstall Road.
It's such fun. Once a year we get together to meet our neighbors, to eat and catch up on what's happened in the last year.
Last year we had approximately 100 neighbors right around here, and this year it looks like we're going to have far more. Even though the weather isn't as great as last year, people seem to look forward to this great day organized by Hannah Diozzi. And it certainly is a great pleasure to be here and enjoy, as Lorraine just said, enjoy your neighbors from the previous years, see what's going on, meet the new neighbors, meet the new additions to the family, and meet each and every one of us. Thank you.
Lay the house on back.
Gotta clear up myself.
Hello, my name is Noah, and I'm 6 years old, and I live on Grace Road.
Welcome to USA.
I live 29 Wellgate Road in Medford, Massachusetts. I'm 7 years old, and I'm really having fun here.
My name is Ben Durfee, and I live on Wellgate Road. And I'm 5 years old. I'm 6 years old, and I'm having fun here.
Hi, my name is Stephanie Silvato. I live at 44 Saltonstall Road, and I'm 8 years old, and I'm having a great time here.
I'm Beth Silvestrini. I live on 43 Saltonstall Road. I'm 6 and a half. I'm having fun.
I want my Medford Square TV.
As you can see, the second annual block party was a great success, and I'm sure there'll be many more to come. Also this weekend, I had the opportunity to visit the second North America NASRUL Conference, which was held at Medford High School. There I had the opportunity to interview the Ambassador to the United States of Bangladesh.
Today I'm here at Medford High School for the second North America NASRUL Conference. This two-day conference, which was held in New Jersey last year, is being hosted by the Taranga Cultural Group of Boston, Massachusetts. This two-day event is filled with keynote speakers such as from Massachusetts and from Bangladesh, and dances, tasting of the food, and other different cultural events. Right now I'm here with the Ambassador of Bangladesh. Your Excellency, how long have you been an ambassador?
I have been in the United States for the last 7 months.
7 months? And how do you enjoy the United States?
It's a great country, great people. I'm happy to be in the United States among friends. Bangladesh shares a lot of things in common with the United States. We have a common global view about peace, about cooperation, about friendship. United States have been very helpful in our economic development and social change. We have been receiving a lot of assistance from the government and people of this country. We have a large... I have been a student...
...to know about your country of Bangladesh.
You see, ours is a developing country. It's trying to fulfill the aspirations of the people to catch up in scientific development, in economic development, in education and technology, but we have a long way to go of the many problems that we face as a nation. One is population growth. We have a very large population with a small and narrow resource base. The other problems, as you know, we have more than our share of floods, cyclones, and other natural calamities, which impede the process of our economic development. But with the help of friends like the United States, and the we are making determined efforts to change the quality of life of our people. And we wish the goodwill and friendship and understanding of all the countries of the world in making our dream come true.
Okay, thank you very much. I hope you enjoy your stay in the United States.
I'm for Square TV!
Thank you, Melissa. That was great. That was Melissa Hurley. We want to welcome Melissa to our Medford Square TV crew, and Melissa will be with us from now on. Congratulations and welcome aboard.
Thanks, Fran. Now here's Scott Harney interviewing Mr. Donald Murphy.
Hi, I'm here with Donald Murphy, Mr. Medford. Now you, how you doing, Donald?
Mr. Reginald.
Now you're at everything. You're at every city council meeting. You're at every traffic commission meeting.
Right.
Saving lives.
Right.
You're involved with that. How long have you lived in Medford for?
20 years.
And where did you live before that?
Somerville.
Somerville. Now what, how did you become so involved in the city?
I just want to know what my tax dollars went to, so I just did.
Okay, now you you seem to know you know, a lot about the city. Now, tell me first, what did you do for a career? You're retired?
Yeah.
From what?
Volkswagen of America.
Oh, good. What did you do there?
I used to work in a warehouse.
In a warehouse. And now you live where?
Up in North Medford.
Okay. And now, you're called the human computer.
Right.
And we're going to show the citizens of Medford why you are the human computer. Okay. We're going to test you on this. How many fire hydrants are there?
1,600.
How many private ways?
295.
How many homes are there?
20,607.
How many streets are there?
422 streets.
And how many of those streets are private ways?
295.
Now, I know you're involved in the city a lot. Now, how would you solve the problems of the city of Medford?
I get the city ways squared away as soon as I could. The best way and the only way.
Now, tell us about the poem you wrote. I know we published it in the paper last year, and you read it before the city council, and I know it moved a lot of people. So why don't you...
One life is all you'll ever live. Slow down before you lose it. It seems a crime to make a time and then not live to use it. The life you save will be your own. And that's the way to keep it, because you only get one life.
What about the MWRA?
I don't care for them.
Why is that?
Because they put a thing on my sink and that didn't work, and they put some kind of a thing in the toilet and that didn't do any good.
Why? What do you mean it didn't do any good?
Well, they're supposed to save water. They're not saving any water.
Maybe they were imposters.
At the thing that the MWRA put on my sink, I had to take it out, because when the water was coming out, it was back up lashing and dropping over that little piece that they put on. So I had to get rid of that. It's been nice talking to you, and you're a wonderful man for all the papers, and I hate to see you go to Cairo, and I wish you could stay here in the city of Medford. So you're a wonderful man. You did a good job. And if you ever come back to Medford, you're welcome on the city of Medford anytime. Thank you very much, and thank you again.
Luck. Keep you a good work up now. And okay, thanks.
Can I say my hat? How did that sound?
Very good.
Is that good?
Excellent.
Show me your hand. Well, you want to move down? Don't move your head. Don't move your head.
Wow, that was great. Gee, Scott, that Donald Murphy really is something. And now here's Anthony Fortunato on Memorial Drive, speaking with some local rollerblade enthusiasts. As a lot of you know, rollerblading has become a very popular sport. And with the summer months approaching, it's only soon to get better.
Hi, I'm Anthony Fortunato, Medford, for Medford Cable TV. I'm down here on Memorial Drive on Sunday afternoon. This is Randy Jenkins, formerly of Medford, currently a student at Berkeley School of Music. And Randy, what are we doing out here today?
Well, we set up the ramp and we set up the cones, and we have rollerbladers just come down here and we go off the ramp and do stuff, and they go through the cones back there. And every Sunday we're here, close Memorial Drive, unless it rains.
And what sort of stunts do you do off the ramp there, Randy?
Well, we can go off, do 360s, everything basically you can do on skis. No flips yet. No flips yet.
And
as of yet.
I see that this is becoming a very popular sport. Yeah. You get a lot of crowds out here, and it's a little inclement today, but...
Yeah, well, when it's really sunny, there's lots of people out here. People come and sit on the sidewalk and watch. And the whole Memorial Drive is closed all the way down, but we're usually just in this area.
Now, can you tell me a little bit about your team? I hear you have a group of guys that come out here and do tricks together.
Well, we have a team, and we do promotional stuff for different businesses. We come down here, we do exhibitions, we show people what can be done with the skates. It's getting real popular. By the end of the summer, it's going to be a mega hit sport. It's an up-and-coming thing.
What kind of safety tips do you have for people that
safety
go off this
tips,
ramp here?
Safety tips off the ramp. Knee pads, elbow pads, wrist guards. I wear gloves. Protect my fingers. I play piano. You know, you got to do that.
Well, thank you very much, hope to see you out here all summer.
Okay.
A man decides after 70 years that what he goes there for is to unlock the door. Well, those around him criticize.
Hi, this is Randy Jenkins from Medford Somerville TV. I'm doing interviews now. I'm here with John Gilmore, the guy that sets this course up. John, can you tell me how long you've been doing this skateboard stuff and about the competitions and stuff?
Skateboarding a long time, about 18 years. And I started setting this up about 2 years ago, training to race in the European Championships, which actually turned out to be the World Championships last year. And didn't do as well as I did wanted to. I got 12. They're really fast.
That's pretty good. Out of how many people, though?
Oh, well, it's actually only, each country only gets to send 5 people.
So
it's kind of like an Olympic selection.
A good amount of people. That's pretty good. That's not bad.
So, I don't know, I had a field of 120 or so.
Okay.
But it's the 5 best from each country. So, but certain countries are stronger than others. So.
And America's not as strong, or?
No, we used to lead it.
Come on, go America.
But we used to lead the world in speed and for slalom for about 15 years. It's kind of like an America's Cup thing. And then just 5 years ago, we lost it to the Italians. Then the Swiss took it away from the Italians, and then the Italians have had it for the last 3 years. This last competition I was in was really neat because every single country did better in a certain discipline than the others. What you see over here, we've got 3 different types of slalom set up today. We've got on the left American giant slalom, the middle is European special slalom, and then just a single line of parallel slalom. And the spacing changes throughout the course. There are rhythm breakers set up there, and it helps you get better control for just all around skating.
Okay, you gonna make a run for us again?
Oh, sure, why not?
All right, let's see it. This is Anthony Fortunato from Medford Square Cable again, and just here with Randy Jenkins wondering, Randy, how did that feel?
Oh, that felt great.
I love it.
Hi, my name is Peter Petrellis, and I'm the coach of the Angels in the South Medford Youth Baseball, and I want my Medford Square TV.
I know what I'm going to be doing June 14th at noontime. I'm going to be by the side of the Mystic River. What? You haven't heard of it? It's the Duck Derby. Can you imagine about 2,500 ducks being dropped into the river? They'll be racing towards the finish line, and you, as the lucky duck owner, will be competing for many valuable prizes, including overnight stays at the Bostonian Hotel or the Marriott Long Wharf, a gift pack at Anthony Liquors, Red Sox tickets donated by J.J. Ruddy, Panda Palace restaurant gift certificate, Ruggieri's Happy Haddock Restaurant gift certificate, Charles & Company Unisex Salon gift certificate, and 4 $25 cash awards, courtesy of the Salem Street Business Association. What else could you be doing but going down to pledge a duck? Now, if you're interested in picking up a duck, you can pick it up at TCBY Yogurt in Medford Square. It only costs $5. If you purchase 5 ducks, you'll get a 6th duck free. Now, if you have any other questions, you can always call the American Cancer Society at 643-3010. The proceeds for the Duck Derby will be going to the American Cancer Society. What a great family day you'll have. There's music, there's prizes, there's ducks. There'll be great weather, so I'm told by Joe Fortunato of Medford Square TV. So be there. Make sure you stop by and say hi to Joe of Medford Square TV. He'll be at the Duck Derby. And later that night, if you're looking for something to do, go to the Little Theater at Medford High School and watch the live performance of the Frankie Fabulous Show. We'll be starting about 7:30. It's a whole evening of entertainment. We have 2 bands. We have, I can't even tell you because we have many, many surprises. We have many Boston headline guests, and we're going to have a lot of fun. So be there about 7:30. For ticket information, call 395-5993. And now here's Phyliss Patten with Medford High School Basketball Booster Club information.
Hi, Phyliss Patten here with an update on Medford basketball. Some of our boys and girls are presently in AAU basketball, and the boys' team is in a league in Milford. We also want to tell you that the girls are looking for donations for warm-up suits. We have a couple of things coming up, fundraisers, that we hope you'll help us in supporting. We have a bottle drive on Saturday, May 30th at the City Hall parking lot. If you could please bring your cans and bottles between the hours of 10 and 12 noon, we'd really appreciate it. Also, we're having a bake sale on Thursday, June 4th, between 5 and 8 p.m. at Johnny's, Haynes Square. Please stop by. Well, you're on a diet? Okay. How about a bumper sticker or a pin? We have both. We'd love to have you come by. Please support our kids. They really need it. I'd like to tell you that our last meeting of the summer, will be held on Wednesday, June 10th in room C221, Medford High School. Use the community school entrance. Please support us. If you're not a parent, if you're just a person who likes basketball, we need your help. Please support us. Thanks a lot.
We're back here. We're here with Pat Fiorello, who's the director of Little Flowers Tours here. Pat's a well-known Medford resident. In fact, he spends his winters in Florida, and I understand that your license plate says Medford on it.
Yes.
How'd you come up with that?
I like the name, and mm-hmm. I'm proud of Medford.
You must get a lot of reaction in Florida.
I have pride in Medford, so right. I'm not ashamed of to have Medford mm-hmm. on my plate.
So,
and my wife has Mass 1 on her plate.
So you must get a lot of comments then, I would think.
Oh, yeah, we meet a lot of friends this way. A lot of people from New England come from Medford.
Mm-hmm.
Matter of fact, a police officer, a Medford police officer stopped me, he says, and the way he pronounced Medford, we'll get a gag out of it, like everybody. So I enjoy myself having those two plates.
Yeah.
I meet a lot of friends from Massachusetts that way.
That's great. Now, I understand you're organizing a big trip to Sicily for the fall. Why don't you tell me a little bit about that?
My wife and I put a trip together, and it's all Sicily.
Yeah.
We go to Taormina, Scaletta, and go to Messina, different parts of Sicily.
Mm-hmm.
And this way, I started when I went to see my father's
part,
and I really enjoy myself.
Now, your father was born in Sicily?
Born in Sicily,
yeah. You've been there, what, 9 times?
About that.
Wow.
Yes, quite a few times.
Yeah. And you're organizing this mainly for Medford people to see Sicily, right?
That's why most of my people come with me from Medford.
Right.
And
now, you described Sicily as being somewhat of a paradise, weren't you?
It's a real nice mm-hmm. place to go. It's unbelievable to see things, the age that it's in. Now, the roads. In Sicily, they didn't know how to write and read the people over there, so they made the roads on a square, on a mm-hmm. diamond, or a circle, and made one road go north, east, or west, and it made different designs.
Hmm.
And so the people know, just like now, the highways, the main highway is all in green stripe, and mm-hmm. the city highway is in blue.
Hmm.
So you can travel a little faster.
Wow. Now, how did you start doing, tell me a little bit about how you started doing Little Flowers tours. First of all, Little Flowers, that's what your name is, Fiorello.
That's right, Fiorello.
Right.
That's how I got the name, Little Flower.
Yeah.
So I was working two jobs for a good many years,
mm-hmm.
20-odd years.
Mm-hmm.
I worked as a park police, and I worked in a housing, and I worked for the specials.
Mm-hmm.
Specials, you don't get paid, but the other two I did.
Mm-hmm.
And I worked up Rice Pond for a good many years, about, say, 10 years or so. I mm-hmm. worked every Saturday and Sunday I gave up. And the reason I became a police officer. I wanted to send my kids to college, and I need some extras, and I didn't make enough money on one job, and I was moonlighting.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the way I started, and then after I gave up the moonlighting, and I started this program mm-hmm. on trips, and I take people, mostly from Medford, I take, and I have a good crowd of people, and we enjoy ourselves, and partly most of them came from the old West End.
Right.
And we all had to move up this way. I came from the old West End. I was born on another street.
Right. And you moved to Medford in what year?
I was married in 46, and let me see. I'm going to say 57, 56, something around mm-hmm. that time. In the 50s, I bought my house on Bradbury Avenue, and I've been there since. Good 30-odd years I've been there.
Yeah. You've been involved in a lot of Medford activities with the Cub Scouts, Boy Scouts. And,
yeah, I was Mr. Fahey and mm-hmm. Dave Walls, myself, mm-hmm. with the troop 426. And we really enjoy ourselves going out mm-hmm. different trips. We used to go out, about four or five times a year. And we went to different places, and we really enjoy ourselves. Mr. Fade donated the truck from Zani Tile, and Dave Walls, and he was the scout master, and I was the program chairman. And we had, and I had the Pariki kid, and I had Jack McGlynn's kids with me, and I had quite a few. And today they're all grown up, and they have their own family. So it's quite a thing to see. And I always told the kids, another 5 years from now, you'll be taking our place. So you better, you know, straighten up and enjoy yourself now.
Okay, now, Pat, I understand you're also involved in the Holy Name Society as well. And
The St. James Holy Name Society, We had scouts there, and that's the and I was a program chairman there, too, and I was the vice president. And that's the time when Mr. Hampkin was on there. McGlynn's father-in-law was president.
Now you, how many, now name some of the Medford people coming to your trips. I know you also take trips. You take three or four trips a year. You go to the Catskills.
I go, I went to Catskills, and I go to Pennsylvania and different places. I try to bargain for the best price I get. I went to like Atlantic City a few times.
And you always get a good crowd from Medford.
But I don't stay in just a, I don't like to stay in Atlantic City. That's why they lose all their money, so I go someplace for 3 or 4 days, and Atlantic City, one day is enough for the people. That's why I don't want them to lose all their money. But not many winners I had.
Who are some of the Medford people that have come to your tours?
Oh, I had Mr. Walsh, Jim Fahey. I had Mr. Pat Deasis, Nick Mascarelli, and the Mascarelli family. Vanessa family, Zanelli. Or there's quite a few.
We just want to stress, though,
I
that
have
this
quite a few
is
from the high rise from Saltonstall.
But this is a non-profit tour.
No, I don't make a dime.
Right, so you basically just make enough to so that you and your wife can go.
But I get I get a free trip out of it, my wife and I.
That's good.
And that's why we keep the cost down. And I feed them. And I donate my the wine and beer and soda. And
it's
I always
like
have
a community thing, anyway, right?
And I always bring a watermelon, about 30, 40 pounds with me. I wish I could show you my video on that stuff.
Yeah, well, maybe we'll get Joe to put some of the videos in.
And we have quite a few trips we have. And I run about 3 trips a year. And I had the Freedom Trail in Boston. I had that, go to see Paul Revere. You'd be surprised. Many people don't know where Bunker Hill is or Paul Revere home is. So I run that, and we had some good times.
Okay, well, very good. Well, listen, good luck on your trip. And your trip, well, tell me, when is the trip happening?
It goes September, when all the fruit is ripe. All right, and you really enjoy everything. The food is great. And on the trip, it's one price, and it's paid for everything, even up to your wine and your supper time.
That's good.
And you can stay there an extra 2 or 3 weeks if you want to. It's all one price, but you have to tell me.
Good.
Thanks for inviting me.
Very good. Good luck.
Also this past weekend, Medford Square TV traveled into Boston to Jody's School of Dancing annual dance recital. Now here's Tracy Grealish and Irene Pitts performing Beauty and the Beast.
Ever as before.
Wasn't that beautiful? Beauty and the Beast. Tracy Grealish and Irene Pitts. Now we're going to bring you back to Scott Harney. But first, Scott, you really did a great job as editor of the Medford Transcript. I'm sure everyone in Medford is going to miss you. But have fun in Cairo, and we hope to see you soon. Now here's Scott Harney.
This is Scott Harney signing off for Medford Square TV. I'd like to thank you for allowing me to host the show. Thank Joe Fortunato. And even though I'm going to work in Cairo, Egypt, I will keep in touch, and hopefully we'll be having some video installations from Egypt. Now, for our personality winners of the week, Emilius Champa, who is a sculptor of the World War I monument, Rose Salido, the poet, Lillian Bombesi, Bill Heckett, and Rosemary Alfie, who... according to Joe Fortunato, gave great video footage for the Centennial Parade edition of Medford Square TV. Gloria Leone, who was the host of the show last week. Paul Donato, Bob Skerry, Marie Emma, Linda Anacone, and Roland Pavia.
Chestnut tree, wishing well, I'm Jesus.